वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स. सो दिस इज़ आवर सेकेंड वीडियो इन आवर एप्टीट्यूड एंड रीजनिंग कोर्स वीडियो लेसन सीरीज. एंड दोस हु आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, प्लीज वॉच प्रीवियस वीडियो वेयर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ट्रिक्स ऑन मिरर्स, दैट इज क्लॉक्स इन द मिरर. ओके, एंड माय नेम इज़ अश्वथ हेगड़े. So I'm currently pursuing my PhD program in forestry from Institute of Food Science and Technology, Bangalore. And this video lesson series is for those who are self-preparing and not taking any coaching for UPSC CSAT examination. And this course will also help to crack many state services, including forest related recruitments like ACF, Assistant Conservator of Forest, as well as in Rainforest Officers. So here we are going to cover 40 different topics which are very essential. With that we are will also focus on different methods and tricks to solve those problems in a very short period of time with a given time. And we'll also allot some course time for preparing self for comprehensive based questions, which is very important in cracking prelims paper 2. So the one more thing just I wanted to say, in only UPSC CSAT examination aptitude is not counted, but in other exams like banking exams or state service examinations, the aptitude part will be counted for ranking. So even though if it is not counted in UPSC CSAT, but you have to have given more importance for aptitude and reasoning part if you are appearing for state service examinations, where it is important to get rank or qualify for the mains. Okay, how to follow this course? So there is a PDF attached with this video, and you just have to download the video PDF which is attached and take the printout. As I explained in the video lessons, you just have to write the problems in the space given. Okay, just revise the material, same it will serve you as a basic material. Just revise the same material for 3 to 4 times so that you will be familiarized with the methods and tricks how to solve that particular problem. So this will help you to crack the examination. Okay. And this is coded systematically for your easily accessibility. In the last class we have discussed about topics on mirror and handshakes and clocks in the mirror. So we'll continue with solving one more problem on handshake, and then we'll continue to problems on time and work. So this kind of time and work related problems, UPSC stopped asking questions. So still it is you need to know. So it would be helpful for state service examinations also. Okay. Okay. We have understood the problem on handshake. Okay. We'll go to the next problem. Okay, find the total number of handshakes if there are 9 people. So same way, the number is odd number here, so 9 people are there. So you have to, for a trick is, so when the number is odd, keep the number same 9 multiplied by the half of the previous number, that is 8 by half is 4. So 9 fours are 36. Okay, so this many number of handshakes possible if there are 9 people. So in handshakes, remember AB and BA are same. So this will be in the next section, the same thing will come in the permutation and combination. So if they ask how many number of handshakes are possible in permutation combination problem, then it will be problem on combination. Okay. So next we'll go to find the total number of handshakes if there are four people. Okay, same thing. The four is a even number, so half of the number is 2, 3, so 6. Half of the number and previous number. So same thing, the product of half of the number and its presiding number is the trick for solving problems on handshakes. Okay. Next we'll move on to the next topic, that is time and work. So in time and work, there are different kinds of problems which will come in the examination. So one type of problem is like this one. Another type we'll discuss in the next page. Okay, there are 6 people. I cut 12 trees in 8 days, working 4 hours a day. In how many days can 12 people cut 48 trees, working 8 hours a day? So here you have to understand the relationship between time and work. So there is time and there is work to be done, like cutting of trees or making roads, this many kilometers of road constructed in a day. So that will be a work. So time is like one day, within an hour, or 2 hours, 3 hours, or within a month. So there will be one more component called people. So number of people. So these three variables are present in time and work. Time will be there, work done will be there, and number of people. So what is the interrelationship between time and work? So when you provide more time, the work done will be more. So they are directly proportional. That means if I provide one day to construct roads or to cut trees, if I provide 2 days, the same number of people will cut more trees, or same number of people will construct more road. So in terms of kilometers, so they are directly proportional. So that is one type of relationship. Next, work and people. By keeping the time constant, so if you concentrate on work and people relationship, if there are more work, okay, you require more people. So if there is a less work, you require less number of people. So they are directly proportional. That means if you want to cut more number of trees, you need more number of people to be employed for that work. So in the same way, time and people. So here, if you see, keep the work constant, like cutting 12 trees is a work. So keep this work constant. If you provide less amount of time, you require more people. So for example, if I provide only one day, you require 10 people. If I provide 2 days for the same work, if you provide more time, you require less number of people. With less number of people, you can cut that particular trees. That means it is indirectly proportional. So if there are more number of people, you require less time, or if there are less number of people, you require more time, or if there is more time, you require less number of people. If there is less time, then there will be more number of people is required. So it is directly proportional, indirectly proportional, it is directly proportional, and it is directly proportional. So this relationship you have to remember while solving problems on time and work. Okay, so now we'll solve how to solve this particular work. So here, step one is writing the problem in a simplified way. So there are 6 people. There are 6 people can cut 12 trees in 8 days, working hours 4 hours a day. And in the same way, if I write one more, in how many days, the question mark is in how many days, and can 12 people cut 48 trees, working 8 hours a day. Okay, So this is the problem. Write, step one is write down in the simplified way, in this manner. Then circle the, encircle the number with the question mark and box it. Okay, encircle the number which with the question mark and encircle it. That is the step two. In the step three, compare each boxes with question mark box. So compare this box with this particular box, compare this people with this particular box, and compare work hours with this particular box. Okay, each boxes should be compared separately. So here, if you compare people and days, so people and time, if there are 6 people, you require 8 days. If there are 12 people, that means more number of people, you require how many number of days? Less number of days or more number of days? So for 12 people, if there are more people, then you require less number of days. Okay, less number of days means the number which is less should be encircled. So this is the step number 3, where compare each separate boxes with the box with question mark, where people and days, there are 6 people, you need 8 days. If there are 12 people, you require less number of days. That's why the number which is less should be encircled. And compare trees and days, the work done and time. If there are 12 people, you require 8 days. If there are 48 trees, that means more number of trees. So work done and days are how they are related? They are directly related. If there is more work, you require more days. That means for 48 trees, you require more number of days. That means the number which is more should be encircled. And then working hours and days. If I work 4 hours a day, I can cut the trees in 8 days. Okay. If I work hard work, if I work more, I can finish the work in less number of days. So word which is used is less. That's why the number which is less should be encircled. So I will go through this once again. Just remember this. In the initial period, you may find this method. It's a very long one. But in after practicing 2 to 3 times, you will solve this problem in a very short time. The answer which will come is a very exact answer. Okay. Again, step one is write down the problem in a simplified way. And then box the number with the question mark . Okay, write down the problem in simplified way and then encircle the number with the question mark and box it. And compare each section with this separately. Compare people with days. 6 people are there to finish. You require 8 days. If there are more number of people, you require less number of days. That's why 6, the number which is less, should be encircled. Then compare trees with the days, work done. If there are 12 people, 12 trees to cut, you require 8 days. If there are more number of trees, then you require more number of days. The number which is used, the word which is used is more. That is why the maximum number is encircled. Then hours with days. If there are 4, if you work for 4 hours a day, you will finish the work in 8 days. If you work 8 hours a day, if you work hard, you can finish in less number of days. So number which is less should be encircled. Now then write all the encircled number on the numerator, that is 6 into 48 into 8 into 4. All the encircled number should be written in the numerator, and all the numbers which are not encircled should be written in denominator. Okay, 8 get cancelled, 3 1s are 3 2s are, so 4 2s are 8. So answer will be 8 days. So for how many days? So in 8 days you will finish the work. If 12 people work 8 hours a day to cut 48 trees, they take 8 days. So answer will be 8 days. Understood? Okay, if you don't understand, we'll explain the same method in the next problem. Okay, so try this problem. First step is write down the question in a simplified way. That is, 14 people can earn 2,800 rupees working 8 hours a day. How much 18 people can earn working 10 hours a day? So this is the question. So step one is write down the question in simplified manner, and next encircle the number with the question mark and box it. Compare this box with this. If 14 people are there, they earn 2,800. If there are more people, so in a family, if there are 14 people, they earn 2,800. If there are 4 more working people, definitely they will earn more money. So the number which is more should be encircled. Then working hours with money. So if there are 8, if you work 8 hours a day, you will earn 2,800. If you are paid in terms of hours, for per 1 hour, you will be paid 500 rupees. If you work 8 hours, you will earn some amount. If you work 2 hours more, OD, so you will earn definitely more. So number which is more should be encircled. So now all the encircled number on the nominator 2,810, and not encircled number should be in the denominator. So 14 ones are 2s are, okay, 2 4s are, 2 5s are, 45. So 4,500 rupees. So they will earn 4,500 rupees in 18 people will earn 4,500 rupees working 10 hours a day. Understood? Just do the problems in the same method for 10 to 15 problems, so that this method will be internalized for you. So in the examination, you don't have to write this particular problem in a systematic way. You will do it in a very fast. So method we'll see 10 cats. So for this type of problem, you have to understand the relationship between time, people or cats or elephants, whatever it may come, and work done. And there will be also money also involved. So what is the relationship between these four people? If there are more people, you earn more money. If there is more time, you earn more money. If you work more, you will earn more. So they are directly related. Okay. Now, so try this problem. So first step is write down the problem in simplified way. There are 10 cats can kill 10 rats in minute. Time is 10 minutes. In how much time? They are asking how much time can 100 cats kill 100 rats. So killing 100 rats or killing 10 rats, it is the work. So it is the work. This thing you have to understand in the examination. So cats is the people, equivalent to people. So minute is the hours, working hour. Okay, if there are 10 cats, now the number with the question mark should be encircled and make a box. Then if there are 10, now I compare work with hours. Okay, if you provide me 10 minute, I will kill 10 rats. Okay, if you provide me work of more, so it work is killing 100 rats, so definitely I need more time because work is more. So work and time are directly related, so more, the number which is more should be encircled. Then cats with the time, if there are 10 cats, it requires only 10 minutes. If there is more number of people, that means more cat is there, you require definitely less time. So to finish the same amount of work, if there are more cats is there, they require very less time. That is why number which is less should be encircled. Now write all the encircled number on the nominator, and the number which are not encircled should be in the denominator. So 100 got cancelled, 100 got cancelled, 10 got cancelled, answer will be 10 minute. So 100 cats can kill 100 rats in, not in 100 minutes, they do it in 10 minutes. Just follow the steps, you will get the right answer. Okay, so now we'll move on to next one. Okay, try this one, try this problem. Okay, wherever I say try this problem, that means you pause the video and try on your own and continue the video for the explanation. Okay, okay, 7 people. So first step is write down in a simplified form, 7 people are there and they dig 203 kilometer in week, 1 week, that is time is in 1 week. So you see in 14 days they have asked. Okay, in how much can do it 9 people dig in 14 days? Either you convert this week into days or days into week. So definitely week is the easy one. So 14 days means 7 2s are 14, that means 2 week. They asked in 2 weeks how many kilometers of road can be constructed. So the number with the question mark should be encircled and make a box, and then compare people with kilometers. So if there are 7 people, they can construct 203 kilometers in a particular time. If there are 9 people, that means 2 more people, you are employing 2 more people, means in the same amount of time they can construct more road. That means the number which is more should be encircled. Then time with kilometer, if you provide 1 week for certain number of people, they will construct 203 kilometers. If you provide them more time, that definitely the road construction will be amount will be more. That is why number which is more should be encircled. Okay, now write down all the encircled number on the top, then this one is 2. Okay, all the number which are not encircled will be in the denominator. Okay, so this will be like this, 7 ones are 7 2 14, 7 2s are 14, 6 is remaining, 63, 7 9s are 63, that is 29 will be the answer one. So 59 2s are 58, 58 into 9, that will answer will come around 522 kilometers. Okay, so answer is 522 kilometers. Okay, so next problem will be 5th question. Try this one. First step is write down the problem in a simplified way. So there are 15 elephants, can eat 15 sugar cane in 15 days. How much one elephant can eat in one day? Okay, so you have to understand how to write this problem in a simplified way. So encircle the number with the question mark and box it. Compare each box with the encircled box. So 15 elephants are there. They eat 15 sugarcane. If there is only one elephant, definitely it will eat less. So don't consider situational conditions, like one elephant is hungry, so it can eat as much of sugarcane which 15 elephants can eat. So it's a mathematical aptitude reasoning part. So here you don't have to apply situational understanding. So here only one elephant, that means less number of elephants can eat only less number of sugarcane. The number which is less should be encircled. Then days with sugarcane. So here eating sugarcane is the work. So if I provide 15 days, it will do 15 sugarcane. So if I provide only one day, definitely, so in one day only less amount of sugarcane can be eaten. So what we what is happening is, here in this problem you have to understand how to correlate between two components. So that triangle you have to understand in it will come in a very later if you practice more and more problems. Okay, 15 days it will eat 15 sugar cane, that means in one day it will eat less, so number which is less should be encircled. So write the all the encircled numbers on the nominator, and numbers which are in not encircled should be written in the denominator. So answer will be 1/15. So that means it will not eat one sugar cane. 1/15 sugar cane will be eaten by the elephant. Okay. Next. So 42 people can earn. So try this one. So there are 42 people can earn 8,400 rupees. Working hours is 10 hours a day. Then how much 50 people can earn working 12 hours a day? Problem which is similar to the previous one. So how to solve this? Encircle the number with the question mark and make a box. Compare this box with each other boxes. Like, if there are 42 people in the family, they earn 8,400 rupees. If there are more number of people, definitely family income will be increased. So it is 50. So in the number which is more should be encircled. 50 is encircled. Then if they work 10 hours a day, they will earn 8,400 rupees. If they work 12 hours a day, definitely they will earn more money. That is why the number which is more should be encircled. Now all the encircled number should be written in the nominator. That is 50 into 8,400 into 12. The numbers which are not encircled should be written in the denominator. Okay. So 5 2s are 10, that is 1,000. 12,000. So they earn 12,000 rupees if they work, if for 50 people work 12 hours a day. Okay, next. So 10 people, so try this one. Okay. So there are 10 people can construct a wall in 8 days. Can construct a wall in 8 days. In how many people are required to finish the same work in only a half day? So in only a half day you have to finish, construct a wall. So here work is constant, so constructing a wall, it is fixed. So working hours is, it is 8 days So if they want to finish in a half day, how many people are required? So this is the question. So here same, follow the same method, encircle the number with the question mark. Okay, encircle the number with the question mark and then compare this box with, if they work 8 hours a day, they require 10 days. Okay, if they want to finish the same work in only half a day, definitely less number of people required or more number of people required? More number of people is required. So that is why the number which is more should be encircled. So 10, all the encircled number on the nominator, 10 into 8 divided by the number which is not encircled should be here, half. So you have to know the basic method to solve the mathematical problem. So when it is like this, it will come like 10 into 8 into the 2 will become, it will become reverse. So 2, 80, there will be answer is 160. So you require 160 people to finish the same wall in 8 days. Okay. So try this problem. First step is write down the problem in simplified way. So there are 26 people can finish a piece of work in 17 days. So 17 days, how many more number of people needed to need to be employed so that the work is to be finished in 13 days, only 13 days. So if you want to finish the work in 13 days, how many more number of people is required? Okay, so same, the number with the question mark should be encircled and make a box. Compare the other box with this encircled box. So 17 days, if I provide you 17 days, you require 26 member people to finish the work. So if I'm providing less number of days, that means definitely you require more people to finish the same work in that time. That is why, sorry, not this. Okay, the more number of people is required. So that's why number which is more should be encircled. So now write down all the encircled number on the nominator. Okay, and now divide all the number which is not encircled should be written in the denominator. Okay, so 17 to the 34. So the answer is wrong. Why wrong? See, you have to read between the lines. So how many more number of people needed? Already we are employing how many number of people? 26 people are already being employed. So now you require 34 people. That means how many more number of people is required? 34 minus 26, that comes under 8. Okay, so 8 more people you require to finish the work in only 13 days. So in the examination, so simply knowing the tricks method is not sufficient. So in the examination, you have to be very observant. So it will read between the lines. Okay. Try this problem. Six cats can kill six rats in 6 minutes. Okay, how many cats are required to kill 100 rats in 15 minutes? 50 minutes. Okay, now encircle the number with the question mark. So if I'm going speed, just in your video you can slow down. Okay, or if you don't understand, just go back to first problem where I explained the method in very detail. Just repeat the same problem, repeat it for 2 to 3 times, you will understand it better. Then you can solve any problem based on this particular method. Okay, rats, 6 rats is there, you require 6 cats. If there are more work, then you require definitely more number of cats. So number which is more should be encircled. Then if you provide only 6 minutes, 6 cat is required. If you are providing more time, definitely you require less number of cats. You understand the time and people, they are indirectly related. So less number of time, so definitely encircled number 6 into 100 into 6, and the number which are not encircled is 6 into 50. So 50 ones are 50 twos are 2 ones are 2 threes are 3 ones are 3 twos are. Okay, 6 2 is 12. So you require 12 cat, okay, 12 cat to finish the work. So answer is 12. Understood? Okay. So problem number 10. There are 60 guns firing 5 rounds in 6 minutes. Can kill 360 men in 1.25 hours. How many guns are required? You know, required, there is a space that can fire 7 rounds in 9 minutes to kill 980 men. So it's a very long problem. Just try back at home. So let me know the answer. So I will provide answer in my next video. So just try at your home. You will understand whether you got this kind of problem or not. Okay. Okay. So we'll continue this type 2 in time and work in our next video. So keep watching. Thank you.